So hello everyone, my name is Mayank Mishra and I am from Bhilai. It is a city in Chhattisgarh. So I am from Bhilai Institute of Technology and I am pursuing mechanical engineering and I am currently in the third year. And my GRE score, as you all know, is 322 and I have a quantitative score of 167 upon 170 and a verbal score of 155 upon 170. And my analytical score is 3.5.
All right. So a third year student who has got this 322 score, 167 and 155, that is our guest today. So I have a question from one of our audience. What is the right time to give GRE, says Deepak. So Mayank, you've given your GRE in your third year. So can you just tell us why you've given it in third year?
Yeah, the right time is to give it in the third year itself because you'll need to apply for the universities in the deadline start rolling from September or August itself. So you'll be prepared before that. I mean, you'll have 3 to 4 months to prepare your SOP and LOR. So it's the best time to give in the third year.
All right. Ideally, what was your motivation behind pursuing masters, Mayank? Because a lot of students want to do masters, but not very clear on what they want to do. So what was your underlying motivation behind masters?
Okay, so I'm actually a car fanatic. And I'll be pursuing my master's in automobile engineering only. Okay. So in India, I don't see such a huge amount of scope. I mean, there is scope, but there's a little bit. I mean, it's considerably less than the German countries and the and United States. So I'm looking for good automobile companies in the world, like GM, Ford, BMW, Audi, Mercedes. So also, I'm a car fanatic, and I'm quite a detrimental kind of guy. So I love to crash stuff. And if I want a job in an automobile company, I want to be a crash test expert. So that's my motivation.
Wow. All right. So the next part is, which stream would you ideally be specializing in and why? As you said, the car fanatic. So
Yeah, automobile engineering.
Automobiles. All right, automobiles. The next question is, I heard that you told me about Germany or US, right? So which country are you actually looking at right now? Are you going for Germany or are you going for US?
For me, Germany is the number one priority because it's the world leader in automobile section. I mean, the top three world leaders in the automobile section are from Germany. I have been developed in Germany, established in Germany. So for me, Germany is the first priority.
Apart from crash testing, which company would you like to work at?
Okay. Yeah, the car in your picture, the Lamborghini.
All right. Wow. So I had one more question for you, Mayank. Can you please tell me what? Do you have any plans for PhD, probably after your MS?
Yeah, it is a possibility. I'm not ruling it out. So I am not negating it. It is a possibility.
Let us just give us a very brief outline on where exactly did you even think about GRE remotely, and all the way to your day of GRE. A very brief run through. Can you just tell us how it happened, all that?
Yeah, sure. So, as far as I remember, it was August. So, I was browsing through some Facebook pages and saw GRE Edge. It was on my mind that I need to give GRE. I was planning for MS. It was on my mind, but I went through GRE Edge, some online webinar which was going on. So, I joined it, and all of a sudden, I received a 50%. I mean, there was offer to you can receive a 50% flat. Off on the course, that particular course. So I saw the course details and I booked it instantly. So that's where it all started. And after joining, it was a 120 days course. I can say that I had to study even if I did not want to. So GRE has helped me out in that procedure. I was not allowed to procrastinate.
Okay.
I studied through it.
All right. So next question is 167 in quant, Mayank. 167. How did you make it happen?
Yeah, I'm from an engineering background, so I was good in maths, so it was not that difficult for me. But when I joined GRE Edge and I had my first diagnostic test, I scored only 161, so it was a bit of a shock to me. But after joining GRE Edge, I had a number of modules to go through, and I almost revised every concept which I knew and which I did not know that one also. Okay. So I ended up. Almost all the things were quite easy and I had just forgotten them, so I ended up knowing everything, and after that all I needed to do was practice. So I'll say to all the members today that if you join GRES, then you need to get started with the modules, and you need to do all of the modules, even if you know them, so that you can get acquainted with the topic. And you, after you get acquainted, you will be easy to you'll be easily able to solve the questions and practice. And you need to avoid you need to avoid silly mistakes a lot, because I scored 170 twice in my practice tests, but in my final exam I scored 167, and that was all due to silly mistakes. So you need to avoid silly mistakes anyhow.
Okay. 170 in a practice test, and when you go for your GRE, that should feel quite, right?
Yeah.
Exactly. I can understand that feeling. Mayank, sorry to pile on that. So guys, exactly what our guests would say, like, you guys try to practice. And when you talk about practice, what kind of practice did you do, Mayank?
Yeah, I completed all the modules on GRE Edge, and okay, that was enough for the practice part. And after that, I just went through the tests.
All right, the GRE style test.
Yeah.
All right, all right. So, as I said, how different is this GRE style test from this regular notebook or offline round of preparation? Was there any difference?
Huge difference, because if you practice offline, if you take a notebook and just practice the questions, you are not under any pressure situation. Mm. You do not have a time limit to complete the question in. Mm. And in the GRE exam hall, you actually have a timer going on, and you have to complete that question, and you have to finish it correctly so that you can proceed to the next and finish that correctly too. And that timer creates a lot of pressure. So there is a huge difference, and you need to practice the original mock test so that you can get acquainted to it.
All right. So guys, that could be one of the reasons why our guest was able to get that 167 mark. Not only did he practice using in GRE simulated environment, but also the kind of modules that he got to get concepts. The other takeaway I would give you is, as a summary, please avoid silly mistakes. Trust me, I've seen students commit a lot of blunders when it comes to silly mistakes. I remember one of the person actually wrote, you won't believe this, is one of the students who, before joining GRE, she took this test. So she wrote 15 by 85. She cancelled both the 5 and read 1 by 8. So we've had students like that and score high, all right? So try to avoid all that. This happens when you're in a high-pressure situation. So the next question for you from Mayank is, see, as a college student, I can see a lot of students tell me one thing very, very clearly. Always they tell me that, listen, I always procrastinate. I procrastinate until the end of the day. I would not prepare, and last 2 days I prepare. So can you guys... what do you do about it? So how did you cope up with this procrastination part?
That's the same thing which happens to every college student, and am I having mind sums in a month or something? Mm. Not even a month, but 10 days. So I am also procrastinating on that, because there is no one nagging on me. But GREH has a system of having two SFAs, and okay, a verbal SFA and a quant SFA. Mm. And those two people, they will be the devil for a while, because they will nag you day and night. And if you have your Gmail account set up on your phone, you will continuously receive emails from them that can complete the module. And even if you don't want to study, they'll make you study. That's a good point of joining GREH. Hmm. Because they make you study. You can't procrastinate.
I think it's worth it, right? Getting the MS in US dream a reality, that's the objective for GREH, to help you guys get that dream. So...
yeah.
In a way, we are glad to do that, Mayank. Coming back to you, Mayank, can you throw us a little light on how did you go about the entire verbal preparation? What all did you do? What all did you not do? How did you go about it?
Okay, so as soon as I joined GREH, I received a number of links from my SFA, okay, which guided me to some articles to study. Okay. And those were articles from the NY Times and from the aldaily.com.
Okay.
Those articles were scholarly articles, actually, and my SFA asked me to read them, because my first section, my first module was RC, reading comprehension. So reading comprehension contains really scholarly passages. I mean, it's tough to understand at one glance or at one read. So reading those articles actually makes it sure that you will understand the passage in one read, because I never read the passage for the second time. Mm. And reading such passages got me acquainted to it, and I always understood it the first time.
Okay.
So that was just the beginning. Hmm. But after that, when I started attending the modules and RCs, as everyone knows, the options are very, very, very confusing.
Hmm, yes.
And you see five choices. Hmm. You see five choices. You can eliminate one or two, but after that, you get confused among the three and you just mess up. So all I can say on that the among the five choices, one will be always, which will not put into the question. It will be some extraneous information.
Okay.
And some of them, one or two, will be extremes. I mean, they will tell you that something must happen, this will be. Those will also be wrong. It's my observation. And the options containing, then you'll narrow down to two choices eventually. So the options containing much more, might, maybe, those will be the correct ones. That's an observation which I found after preparing for around a month or so only on RCs. And RCs was just hellish for me in the beginning. But at the end, RCs was easy because you understand the passage and you understand the options and you can mark it correctly. So there's nothing easier than that. And you don't need a vocabulary for that too.
Okay.
Because text completion and sentence requirements needed vocabulary. But RC did not need such vocabulary.
All right.
So RCs became easy for me.
All right. So RCs was ensure that was made easy for you.
Yeah.
All right.
And for RCs also, I like to say that never depend on the extraneous information which you already know about the topic.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you might know the topic beforehand, but don't use that information to answer the question. That might be misleading too. Only use the passage.
Okay. I hope that gives you enough clarity, guys. So now, Jay Kotia has a good question. Mayank, how did you manage time for practice? So how much time do you spend every day and how did you manage time? Time management, how did you learn it?
Yeah, time management came with practice because I took a lot of time to read the passage in the beginning, but eventually practicing I learned that I had to complete a passage, reading the passage in 2 minutes and then answering all the questions in the particular time frame to complete the number of questions. So I practiced a lot and I tried to reduce my time as much as possible, and at the end I was able to do so. Was it.
So, and the GRE's test is designed in such a way that you have to finish a certain preparation in a certain time, right?
Yeah, you have to finish it.
All right. So I believe that will help in time management practice as well, Jay Kotia. The next question is, any suggestions for the working people? Kiran Chhatre says working people. As working people, I believe online portal might be effective. What do you think, Mayank?
Yeah, for working professionals, I'd say I've attended a number of webinars and a number of working professionals have said that GRE is the best for them because it gives you time flexibility. You can join anytime. You can complete the module anytime. You can access it anywhere. So working professional, it is very good.
All right. So I hope that answers your question, Kiran Chhatre. The next question is, a lot of people are already posted that question. How did you go about the entire word learning part? This word learning seems to be a huge pain for a lot of people. The questions I've got is, how many words did you learn? How many words did you learn again? And how much time did you spend each day? So can you answer this question, Mayank?
Yeah, so as soon as I started my preparation, I was given a link to the app called WordBot.
Okay.
And you all might be knowing that WordBot is a fantastic app for the purpose of learning words. So as you're doing your RCs, make sure that you do at least 25 to 30 words per day with the RCs itself, because it won't help you in the RCs, but it will help you in the future when you start preparing for TC and SE. I mean, the text completion and sentence equivalence parts, you cannot solve them without a proper vocabulary. So even if you're preparing for the RCs, do prepare for your vocabulary too and improve the number of words you've got right now. So I prepared around 1200 words from WordBot and around 300 or 400 more from practice. I mean, I always used to write down the words which I came across with while preparing, while my preparations and my practice tests.
Okay. So on a summary, WordBot tool is definitely something that you guys can use. If people are do not know the WordBot tool, it's WordBot. That's the tool that I think our guest has used as much as possible. Now, Kiran Chhatre has a question. Are 4,000 words really necessary? That's the question.
No.
Kiran says. So how many words would you recommend for our audience today, Mayank?
It's not about the number of words. It's about the idea of the words, and I would say the word board list 6, 7, 8 and 1, 2, 3, they're sufficient.
All right. So guys, you could note this down. The word board list 6, 7, 8 and 1, 2, 3 are quite efficient enough for you to target the 320 plus score. Now,
after those word lists, you can use the number of practices to know new words, because the words are repeated quite often. I have seen that.
All right. So guys, that's actually a valuable insight that I've just have provided, because usually people go to 2,500 words. They don't realize it as if it's just words repeating. If you're able to follow a pattern, you will be able to do that. The next question is, Uday Angan wants to know, every day, how much amount of time do you give for GRE preparations in that 2 months?
in that 2 month it was above 3 hours. I mean, at least 2 hours for verbal, and quantitative I used to give 1 hour just so that I can revise the concepts.
All right, all right, fantastic. So thank you so much. Okay, the next question, I already got it from the audience. Your name is Yamu Hiyadin. Yamu wants to know, how did you go about your AW preparations? What all did you do for that?
For AW, I wasn't serious, I can say that. And as I was not serious, I can say this to everybody, be serious about it. It is not easy, and you need to practice it at least 4 or 5 times before the actual exam. So I had my AW modules, but I was, I don't remember exactly, but I was not able to do it properly. I attempted only 1 or 2 of them, and I scored really bad, but I did not pay attention before the last week of the GRE. So before the last week, I came across AW that I had to attempt it, so I'll have to study for it too. And while attempting it, I found that it was not that easy, and you need to know properly what to write. And I mean, if it's an issue, you need to write for an issue. It's an argument, you need to oppose it always. I was so wrong in the initial stages that I wrote, I mean, exactly the opposites of it. So you need to practice for it, and you need someone to evaluate them for you too. Because attempting a AW section right in the examination hall will not help you. So go through the GRE samples. GRE Edge provides many samples for the topics. It has a pool of topics too. Go through them, and also ETS website also provides many sample responses too. So go through them and be serious about it. AW isn't easy.
So overall, what was your experience with GRE Edge like, Mayank?
GRE Edge is very, very good service. It's a selfless organization, I'd say, because when I was over with the GRE Edge modules, I mean the course was over. I had a 1-day course, it was over, and I had my exam in 1 month.
Okay.
So even after my course was over, I received continuously many calls from GRE Edge that if you need any help, contact us, we'll help you, we'll provide you free tests, we'll provide you any number of tests you want. And that was fantastic on GRE Edge's side, and I received a free test from GRE Edge, and I attempted and I scored 320 in it too. That was just before 15 days of the exam. So GRE Edge is always on my side and always helping.
Quite glad to do that, Mayank. As long as we produce such beautiful alumni for us, it's a privilege to have you with us. Now, one of the questions of the audience is, what was your D-Day experience like? On the day of your GRE, how did you feel? What all did you do?
It was just like any exam. I was tensed.
And, okay.
I actually ate a lot, which I shouldn't have. So I was waiting in the exam hall just for the 10 minutes break so that I could go to use the washroom.
Okay.
And that was a tough time for me.
All right.
But not that difficult that you should be scared of it. The environment is good. And one thing I'd like to add here is that during the AWA part, I mean, that's just in the beginning of the exam. So in the AWA part, you will be sitting with, I mean, I was in New Delhi. My center was in New Delhi.
Okay.
So my center was quite a big center, and I had around 30 to 40 students along with me. So all of them are sitting by your side and typing vigorously. And it's like machine guns with muffled sounds, you know. It was too loud. So okay. Put on your headphones or practice in such an environment beforehand, because it will make you a bit tensed. I was tensed.
So that is actually quite a valuable tip. A lot of students do tell us as well that keyboard sound, no? It kind of disturbs you a little. So I hope that is a very valuable tip for most of you guys in the audience. Thank you so much, Mayank Mishra. As I say, guys, you can definitely aim that score if you just do your things right. Chase 320 is this program, the championship program that's available, the complete GRE compact. All you have to do is bit.ly/chase320. Go to this link, sign up, and start your GRE preparations today. If not, the best part is, follow our webinars, bit.ly/GRE webinars. That is the place where you can get a lot of more information that is very valuable for most of you guys. So Akshay also says, thank you, Mayank, for your valuable time and tips. So thank you, Mayank, for joining us, and for each and every the guest. If you have more questions, anything regarding GRE or admission, you know our contact information, 988-445-3276. Call us, WhatsApp us, or SMS. In fact, if you mail us, it will be much more preferred, info@greh.com. All right, so until I see you in the upcoming seminars, this is Vishnu signing off. A very good evening, and take care, guys.